It feels so good to be back out again.
It's just so beautiful.
This is definitely a bit of us. Chandavan in Chandavan Square. It is full of bars and restaurants. I've already found love, Molly said. I'm only washing the hands. That means I can stay in Prizren forever.
Cheers.
First tasting. Papa, which is essentially a Kosovan kebab.
Finally made it up to Kalaja Fortress.
It looks like you're in the desert.
Good morning, guys, and welcome to Prizren, Kosovo. We've extended our stay here due to the lockdown, which has now finished. So today we are able to go out and explore. We are staying here at Hotel Dennis, which is just outside of the old town. And it's really, really nice. We have this humongous balcony, which overlooks the mountains and sort of residential area. We have our huge double bed, we've got a huge telly, and the bathroom is amazing. There's like this massive bath that has jacuzzi and lights on it. It's also nice, they've been really kind to us. We've got all our toiletries and a little bath set. But as I said, the lockdown is over, we can explore, we can get out, and I'm ready to go and explore Prizren finally.
It feels so good to be back out again. After lockdown eating takeaway pizza and numerous burek, we are back out exploring this beautiful Kosovan city. It sits on the foothills of the Sar Mountains and is separated by the Lombardy River. We're now walking along the Lombardy River, which is equally as beautiful as the city. You have numerous bridges to cross to get from the new to the old town, but the old town is where we'll start. Our hotel is actually conveniently located in the new town, right near the Lombardy River.
If you wanted to get a picture of Prizren, then the Stone Bridge is the place to do it. It's like the most famous picture spot here. You can see why it's beautiful. You can see the whole of the town behind you. You can see the fortress as well. It links you to the main part of the city, which is Chandavan Square. It's just so beautiful.
It is not an uncommon sight to see an Ottoman bridge in the Balkans. We've seen our fair few ourselves. We've seen a lot, actually. To see one as poignant as this, in a city centre, it is just so beautiful. It was believed to be built around the 15th century and then was destroyed by floods and rebuilt in the 1980s, I believe. There are numerous bridges to take here. You've got the Arasta Bridge to my left, you've got the Lovelock Blue Bridge to my right, but you can't come to Prizren and not cross this cobbled bridge into Chandavan. This has to be my favourite part. As you come across to Chandavan in Chandavan Square is all the bars and restaurants
it's
lined along
bustling.
The river.
It's so bustling, and it's probably the main spot for locals and tourists to hang out.
This is definitely a bit of us. Chandavan in Chandavan Square. It is full of bars and restaurants. I cannot wait for later to get a paya. After the lockdown this weekend and not being able to go to bars, I think I have like paya withdrawal symptoms. Oh, it's so bustling today. I absolutely love this. In the center of Chandavani Square is this Chandavani fountain, which if you believe the story, if you have a drink from it, you will stay in Prizren forever and find love. I don't need to find love. Have I found love, Molly?
Yes.
She's laughing, that doesn't sound good. So I'm just gonna wash my hands today. Oh, that is so fresh, you can imagine. That comes down from the Saar Mountains.
How do you feel? Do you feel loved?
I feel good. Apparently I've already found love, Molly said. I'm only washing the hands. That means I can stay in Prizren forever. I would be under there drinking all day if that was payout.
Literally a 1 second walk from Shandarani Square is the Sinan Pasha Mosque, which is basically an Ottoman mosque built in the heart of the city of Prizren. It was built around the 1600s and it is a very dominant feature in the skyline. It is the one thing that you see when you come in, and most of the hotels are built around it so that you have a view of it, and it's pretty spectacular. It is huge.
With Prizren being the historic center of Kosovo and actually being one of the oldest settlements in all of the Balkans, I think it'd be rude to come here and not check out at least one mosque, especially with Islam being the biggest religion in all of Kosovo. I feel like we need to go inside this one. It looks amazing from outside, and I think we can go in as long as there isn't a prayer taking place right now.
We've got trousers on,
We have got trousers on. I must add also, while we've been here for a few days during lockdown, we've noticed there is so many mosques here. Maybe the most mosques I've ever seen in a city.
There's like one every few steps.
Be prepared for the call of prayer at 5 a.m. every morning to wake you up. That was actually well worth going inside. You couldn't actually take your camera, so luckily I was allowed to use my phone, and they actually just finished their call for prayer, so had to wait a little bit to go inside. But the artwork on the walls is actually really, really impressive and worth going in for itself. I think it was actually done, the artwork, in the 1900s, so it's a lot newer than the mosque itself, and you can see that when you go inside. It is really, really nice. But we have got a brand new friend.
Another Hello. One. He's obsessed with us. I think they can just tell that I love dogs. He's followed me the whole way.
And you'll actually notice all around Kosovo, especially Prizren and Pristina, the two main cities, that these guys have a little chip in their ear. So
there's been so many.
So if a stray comes up to you, stroke it. They've had all their injections.
They've been injected and they've been neutered. And I think that's a really good thing because it stops puppies.
He's weighing up the wall.
It stops puppies and it stops mums being ill when they give birth. I just think it's really good all round. We've come into Alhambra, or Tisaila, depending on what you call it. Alhambra is the traditional name, and it is a riverside restaurant. As you can hear, the river is flowing right next to us. We're just by the stone bridge, which is just behind that this way. It's a really traditional restaurant. We really wanted a paella, thanks to lockdown being over.
Finally, cheers. First taste in 2 days.
Two days
too long.
It's been a long time.
How good is this location? Stone bridge behind me. I've nearly actually finished my beer. I've been so thirsty. Them 2 days without drinking any paella have got to me. We actually wanted to eat something traditional today. We've been living on pizza during the lockdown, so we went for kebapa, which is essentially a Kosovan kebab. I think it varies in what's in them. I believe that these ones will be beef and lamb, or one of the two, or mixed together. You get your bread with it. I'm not exactly sure of the best way to eat it, but I'm going to break a little bit of my bread open.
And you get a salad, so you do actually have to put salad in it too.
I'm dodging the salad. I always dodge the salad. Cut a nice big bit. That looks really good. And this place, if you type in where does the best kebapa, here will come up. There you go. You make like a little sandwich. Oh wow, it's really good. Yeah, that is really good. It is just essentially, it tastes a little bit like a burger. I think these ones will definitely be beef.
They're like tiny little sausages, aren't they?
They're like little sausage burgers, kebab. Really good. Goes really well with a beer.
Look at the difference you're packing in the salad.
Yeah, I know. I was just about to say, unlike Matt, I am not a salad dodger. They are so good, and the bread, so soft. Like, look at this. Can you see that?
Yeah, these are beef as well.
These are beef, we asked, and it does translate trebapa. What did he say?
Trebapi.
No, it's trebapa, I think. And he said it translates directly into English as a kebab.
So good.
So fresh.
that was so good. And for only €8 for two meals, three beers, I decided to have a second one. It's been too long since the last one, so I had to eat some more. We're now heading back over the bridge into the new town.
So we have come on over into the new town and we have found the mother of God of Levis, I think. Don't come for me for my pronunciation. But this is a 14th century Serbian Orthodox church, which is actually closed. It's covered in barbed wire. You're not allowed in there. It's definitely not been used for some time. But it's a huge, huge complex.
You'll actually notice that there's a police booth here right next to the church, being that it was restored by the Serbians and made a Serbian Orthodox church. That is why there is the barbed wire. In 2004, quite a lot of it was destroyed during the political unrest. But it does actually have a really long, rich history. It was a church over 1,000 years ago. It was then turned into a mosque for over 500 years, and then turned back into a church by the Serbians, which of course caused the unrest. Unfortunately, you can't gain access. You can ask to get inside, but there's no one around at the moment and it is all barricaded up. It is part of the UNESCO World Heritage Site, which is pretty cool. Hopefully in the future it can be restored and people can visit it again.
We actually should have done that this morning, as it was right next to our hotel and the complete other side of the bridge. But right next to it was actually the Turkish Baths, which makes up two of the four UNESCO World Heritage Sites
closed
here in Prizren. It was closed due to coronavirus, but we're heading up to the castle now. As you can tell, I'm out of breath. It's a long way up.
The views already are absolutely incredible. It should only take 10 to 15 minutes. But you never know with Molly.
15.
You never know with Molly. On your way up, you'll find the Church of the Holy Saviour. And again here, it's padlocked for similar reasons to the church in town. But again, another lovely church. Hopefully it can be open soon.
Finally made it up to Kalaja Fortress. It wasn't actually that bad. It's just so steep. You get here so quick because of how steep it is. But this place is crazy. It's very vast and you can see where it's been sort of refurbished. It's in really good condition. It's very well looked after and it dates back to around the Bronze Ages, which means it's pretty old. They've also got like factual signs everywhere, which is nice, but we're here for one thing, and that is to sit up here and watch the sunset over the city. Honestly, this is unreal. I'm just literally sitting here and watching the sunset. It's amazing. The real views are that side though. You can see the whole city behind me. You can see the Sar Mountains and the other side of the city that way. It's just beautiful.
They've actually got these really nice paths. We're running to the front now because the sun is hopefully starting to set. It's really hazy tonight, but they've got the signs everywhere. And this space just in front of us here that actually used to be a mosque, which is, I don't know why you don't really associate a mosque to being a castle.
In the desert, because this all here is all hazy all the way along here. The sun is setting there. You can actually still see this part of it, but yeah, look at that.
It's actually incredible. You come up here and you don't realize how vast the city of Prizren is. I suppose it is the second most populated, biggest city in all of Kosovo. But you come up here and you can see the new town is huge. The old town obviously is a little bit smaller, but the sunset behind the mountains, it is going that perfect like red, orange,
it's just starting.
All sorts of colours. It is perfect up here.
and the sun has gone. Look at the orange glow giving it though. And I just, like I was saying, look at the vastness of this city. I really did not expect it.
And that is the sun gone. And oh my gosh, does it get cold. Once that sun leaves the sky, it is freezing. My fingers are blue, my nose is running. It's time to get back down. Thank you.
That sunset was so good. Because the bars are back open, we had to come to our favourite that we found Friday night before the lockdown, which is Gatsby. We have got our Paya beer, unfortunately not draft. We're having a draft in a little bit. And I'm not sure what to get there. It's basically Western food here. Call for prayers, gang. It's actually, yeah, it's all Western food, not necessarily traditional food. It's got your pastas, got your pizzas, got your burgers, all of that. And after eating traditionally at lunch, I think we can cheat for dinner.
This looks incredible. I've gone for a vegetable pasta with like a creamy cheese sauce. Matt's gone for vegetable risotto. This place is so modern. It does such a big menu. It even has like burritos.
All the meat at lunch, right? All the meat at lunch. So
we had so much meat, so we went for vegetarian today just to let the meat come down. Sometimes meat doesn't always digest, but can you smell the cheese?
I love this place though. It's like so modern inside, sitting on the riverfront.
And we have a lovely heater outside. We decided to sit outside today.
Cheers.
Oh, cheers for your half beer.
One on the way.
Cheers. Absolutely love sitting out here. We are back at Hotel Dennis. This has been a lovely hotel. Everyone is so friendly. The service is amazing. And most importantly, the rooms are great. Oh my gosh, it is so cold. And food was so good.
Really good, wasn't it? Incredible. Oh,
it
does. If you want authentic Western food, that is the place to go. We've just got a payer from the shop as it is nearly time to be back in your room for lockdown.
We've just really thoroughly enjoyed Brisbane. I'm so glad that we waited until today.
Oh, what a beautiful city. It's got to be so far, the most beautiful city in Kosovo, possibly the Balkans.
Cheers.
Gazor. We've got the incredible fortress, you've got the incredible old town, the bridge, the food. What was it we had for lunch?
Trabapi.
Molly, we say terrible it, pronunciation.
No, that's right. We say it wrong. We say kebapi because it's spelled with a Q, but it's actually pronounced with a C, so it's kebapi.
Yeah, but I would highly recommend Prizren. Add it to your Balkans itinerary. Beautiful
100%.
City, beautiful old town. Again, Kosovo is blowing us away. This country is just showing us so much more than the media portray. Make sure you do come here, and if you do, come to Prizren. Hopefully we'll see you tomorrow because there are new regulations being...
Before you say that, can I just say we've never met friendlier people?
Either. Most friendly people ever.
So friendly.
Mm-hmm. New regulations will be released by the government tonight. So hopefully we'll see you tomorrow and we won't be on our way to the airport. Gazor.